In this class, we can study about quartile. A quartile divided a data set into 4 equal parts. Then what is quartile? Then quartiles are the measures which divide the data into 4 equal parts. Each portion contains equal number of observations. There are 3 quartiles. The first quartile denoted by Q1 or lower quartile has 25% of item. Then there are 3 quartiles Q1, Q2, Q3. Lower quartile first 25% and first 75% of the item we are calling as Q3. Then next one is second half, that one is the quartile denoted by Q2 and that one is median. Q2 is the median. It is the 50% of items. You can see here first 25, suppose this is the full data, first 25%, you can see here first 25%, this is the lower quartile or this is the Q1. Okay, this one is the 50%, this is the median or Q2. Okay, then this is the last 75%, this is the Q3. Okay, these are the quartile Q1, Q3 denote the 2 limits within which central of the data lies. Then here lower quartile is Q1, median, this is the Q2, middle, okay, that one is the Q2, and upper quartile is Q3. Then a quartile divides a sorted data into 4 equal parts. Each represents the data set, first 25% Q1, 50% Q2, that one is median, and Q3 is 75%. The first quartile Q1, also called lower quartile, it is defined as the middle number between the smallest number and the smallest number and the median of the data, 25th percentile, that one is the Q1. Okay, the second quartile is Q2, that one is the median, then median is Q2. Okay, the third quartile, Q3, called upper quartile, is the middle value between the median and the highest value of the data set. Here, in this one, you can see there are 11 data items. In that one, then median is the 5th item. Means this is the lower quartile. And this one is the middle item. That one is Q2. That one is median. And Q1 is 5. And Q3 is 75%. Means 9th item. Okay. Q3 is the 9th item. Means this is 3rd. Here how many in numbers items are there? 3, 3, 6, 6, 9, 11 items are there. In that one, 3rd item is the Q1 and next one, middle item is 5th item is Q2. And upper quartile is 9th item. Then how we can find out Q1? We can apply the equation and we can study Q1. Q1 equals to n plus 1 divided by 4th item. Q1 is the n plus 1 divided by 4th item. This n is the number of items in this observation. This is the question. In this question, we need to find out the quartile for the data. Quartiles for the data here, 25, 18, 38, 15, 5, 10, 35, 40, 45. First, we need to arrange the data in ascending order. Means first number is 5, 8, next biggest number is 8, next one is 10, next biggest number is 15, next one is 18, next one is 25, next one is 30, next one is 35, next one is 40, next one is 45. Okay, then Q1 equal to n plus 1 divided by fourth item. Which one is n? N means number of items. How many number of items are there in this observation? 10 items. Then 10 plus 1 divided by fourth item. Answer is 2.75. Fifth item means 2.7 fifth item means second item plus 3/4 7.75 means third item minus second item means which one is third item second item which one is second item 8 plus 3/4 divided by 10 minus 8 third item minus second item. Then we will get answer as 8 plus 4, 3/4 into 2, 8 plus 1.5. Then answer is 9.5th item. Here you can see another one problem. In that one, you need to find out the quartiles 22, 26, 14, 30, 80, 11, 35, 41, 12, 32. First, you need to arrange in ascending order. First, which one is the first number? 11. Smallest number 11, 12, 14, 18, 22, 26, 30, 32, 35, 41. Then, equation is Q1 equal to size of n plus 1 divided by 4th item. Then what is n here? It is 10. 10 plus 1 equal to 4th item. Answer is 2.7 5th item. Means 2nd item plus instead of 3/4 you can write it as 0.75. 0.75 means after 2nd item which item will come? Third item will come. We need to take third item. Which one is the third item? It is 14 minus second item. Okay. That one is the steps. Then which one is second item? Second item value is 12 plus 0.75 into 14 minus 12, answer is 13.5. Okay, this is the steps to find out the quartiles. Then how we can find out Q3? For finding Q3, we need to apply the equation Q3 equal to 3 into here Q3, that reason we are giving here 3, 3 into n plus 1 divided by 4th item. Then what is the n here? Already we studied n is 10, okay. Means 5, 8, 10 like that values n is in this question how many number of items are there? 10. Okay, then 10 plus 1 divided by 4th item, 3 into 2.7 5th item, then answer is 8.2 5th items. Then instead of 1/4, you can give 2.25 also. Then 8th item plus 2.25 into 9th item minus 8th item. Means if it is 8.2 or 8.5 or 8.9, means you need to give 9th item minus 8th item. Means 40 minus 35, 35 plus 1.25, 36.25. Then next one we can study about mode. Then what is mode? Suppose a manufacturer is the most appropriate measure to find out like these values. Then what is mode? Mode means what is mode? Mode is the most frequently observed data value. Mode means most frequently observed data value, means which number is repeating more times, that one is mode. Okay, mode means most frequently observed data. It is denoted by M0. Mode is denoted by M0. Here one question is there, discrete series. We need to find out the mode. Consider the data 1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 5. The mode for this data is, which one is most repeating? It is 4. That reason we are taking mode as 4, because 4 is repeating or frequently occurs 2 times. That reason it is mode. Look at the following discrete series. Here you can see 10, 2, 28, 30, 20, 40, 10, 55. 30, 20, we know this 20 is repeating more. The value of mode is 30. Then which number is repeating 20 times? 30. Okay, that reason here mode is 30. Okay, which one is repeating more time? That one is the mode. Okay, then what is the equation for finding the mode in a continuous series? Mode, how we can find out? M0 equal to L plus D1 divided by D1 plus D2 into H. Okay, here L is the lower limit of the model class. L is the lower limit of the model class. D1 is the difference between frequency of the model class and frequency of the class preceding the model class. Okay, ignoring the sign, preceding model class, what is the value? We will take as D1, and D2 is the difference between frequency of the model class and frequency of the model class and succeeding model class. H is the class interval. That one is the step. Here you can see one problem is there. Calculate the value less than 50, less than 45, less than 35, less than 30 and less than 20. As you can see, in case of cumulative frequency, we know here. Then in this question, first we need to make into class. Okay, how we can make into class? Like 40, less than 40 means 42, less than 50 means we can take class interval as 10, then 40 to 50, then less than 45 means 45 to 50, then less than 40 means 40 to 45 means it is less than. Then first we need to write the classes, like less than 40, 45 to 50, then 40 to 45, then 35 to 44, next one 30 to 35, like that we can make classes. And after that, first we can make classes, and after that values are there, we need to find out these values in less than cumulative frequency. 97 minus 95, 95 minus 90, this one. Then 90 minus 80, then here 80 minus 60, next one 30 minus 12, then 12 minus 4. Okay, then we got the less than cumulative frequency. Then we need to find out which one have highest frequency. Which one have highest frequency? This 25 to 30 have the
highest frequency. That one is 30. That one is the 30. Then the value of the mode lies in the 25 to 30 class interval. Then now we understood that this is the model class. This one is the model class. Okay, this is the model class. And then we need to find out the D1 and D2. Okay. Then here, which one is D1? D1 is 30 minus 80. This one is the D1. D2 is 30 minus 20. How we can find difference between the model class and succeeding. This is the preceding class and this is the succeeding classes. Then 30 minus 18. Here, this 30, this is the model class and this one is the preceding class and succeeding class. Succeeding class and preceding class. Then 30 minus 18 and 30 minus 20. Then we will get D1 and D2. Then we can write it as 25 plus 12 divided by 12 plus 10 into 5. Then we will get the answer as 27.273.